Good day from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's see how amides react with lithium aluminum hydride. When thinking about amides, I want to treat them like esters. The reaction of an ester is on the top line with lithium aluminum hydride. The ester forms two alcohols, 1, 2. If amides do the same thing, then I would expect an amide to make an alcohol and an amine. And that's what we show on the middle line. This is what we would expect. We'd expect an alcohol and an amine. In both cases, we're breaking the CO or the CN bond to the carbonyl. Well, amides are not the same as esters. Oxygen is not the same as nitrogen. Instead of breaking the CN bond to the carbonyl, lithium aluminum hydride instead rips the carbonyl oxygen, and now I'm on the bottom line, rips that carbonyl oxygen completely out of the amide. The two CO bonds of the carbonyl are replaced by two CH bonds. The CN bond is untouched. The key difference is in the first tetrahedral intermediate. Let's draw this to the right. So we get our O minus, the hydride attacked, and there is our nitrogen. If this were a typical acid derivative, I would kick out the nitrogen as a leaving group. The problem is, nitrogen is a terrible leaving group as an anion. It won't leave. As a result, somehow, and I won't try to draw the mechanism, the oxygen leaves. The final product of the reaction is an amine. Fun fact, the reduction of amides to an amine with lithium aluminum hydride is actually one of the most important methods for making amines. Now, amides are electrophilic and they can react with lithium aluminum hydride. However, organolithium reagents don't tend to react well with amides. So our only good nucleophile we have for reacting with amides is lithium aluminum hydride.